Hello students, today we are going to study class 10 science chapter 5, that is periodic classification of elements. So let's start with that chapter, periodic classification of elements. So there are 118 elements known to us, and all these have different properties, or the elements are having different properties. To make the study of these elements easy, these elements has been divided into few groups in such a way that elements in the same group have similar properties. So before starting, let's start the chapter with let's study the definition of classification. So what is classification? So placing similar groups and species together is known as classification. And what is the importance of classification? Classification is needed to class easily. Classification is needed to easily understand the properties of different elements in a periodic table. Elements with similar properties are placed in one group to understand them easily. So there were different scientists who tried the periodic classification of elements. So here we are going to start with Dobernier. Dobernier classified elements in increasing order of their atomic masses into groups of three elements called triads. In each triad, the atomic mass of the middle element was approximately equal to the average atomic mass of the other two elements. Here we can see the example how Dobernier classified into triads. So he considered three elements in which atomic mass of the central element is the arithmetic mean to the other two elements. Here we can see in case of atomic mass, here we can see the atomic mass of lithium, sodium and potassium. The atomic masses of lithium is 7, sodium is 23 and potassium is 39. And the arithmetic mean of lithium and potassium is 23. That means it is approximately equal to sodium. But there was some limitations. So what was the limitation of Dobernier triads? He was able to identify only three triads from the elements known at that time. After that, Newland came with the Newland law of octaves. So when the elements were arranged in the order of increasing atomic masses, then every eighth element had properties similar to that of the first. And he compared this to the octaves found in the music and called it the law of octaves. And he called it law of octaves. He says that elements are arranged in such a way that every eighth element has same properties as in the first element. And according to him, only 56 elements are found in which is a drawback of Newland's law of octaves. So what are the limitations? The law was applicable to elements up to calcium only. It contained only 56 elements. Further, it was assumed by Newland that only 56 elements existed in nature and no more elements would be discovered in the future. And in order to fit elements into the table, Newland adjusted two elements in the same slot and also put some unlike elements under same slot. For example, cobalt and nickel are in the same slot, and these are placed in the same column as fluorine, chlorine and bromine, and which have the very different properties from these elements. Iron, which resembles cobalt and nickel in properties, has been placed differently away from these elements. That means the classification was not proper and the same elements were placed differently. So now Mendeleev. Now another classification was given by Mendeleev. So Mendeleev used atomic masses as the basis of arrangement of elements. According to him, elements were arranged in increasing order of their atomic masses. He believes that there was a periodic reappearance in their physical and chemical properties. So when according to Mendeleev, when elements are arranged in the order of increasing atomic masses, the elements with the similar properties occur at regular intervals. So what is the Mendeleev's law? The properties of elements are a periodic function of their atomic masses. So Mendeleev Mendeleev predicted the existence and properties of some elements, and his prediction was 100% correct, and he called the groups as columns and periods as series. So what are the criteria of Mendeleev's periodic table? The criteria was increasing atomic mass, and grouping together of elements having similar properties. The criteria was increasing atomic mass and grouping together of elements having similar properties. So what are the merits and demerits of Mendeleev periodic table? So the merits are, some gaps were left for the undiscovered elements like gallium, germanium, etc. He predicted properties of elements on the basis of their position in the periodic table, and when inert gases were discovered later on, it could be placed in without disturbing the existing order. It was the merit. So what were the limitations or anomalies of the Mendeleev periodic table? The first was position of hydrogen. So position of hydrogen was uncertain, as it resembles both alkaline, methyl and halogens, and it was kept in group 1A. And position of isotopes. Position of isotopes, no separate position was given to isotopes in his table. And the last one is, third limitation is, the atomic masses did not increase in a regular manner. That means the wrong order of atomic masses of some elements could not be explained. For example, we can see that cobalt is heavier than nickel. Cobalt is heavier than nickel, but kept before nickel. So here we can see the Mendeleev periodic table. What were the features of the Mendeleev periodic table? It contains 8 vertical columns called groups, and it contains 7 horizontal rows called periods. So what is modern periodic table? So D. Mendeleev discovered the modern periodic table in the year 1869, and modern periodic law was given by Henry Moseley in the year 1930. So according to modern periodic law, the properties of the elements are a periodic function of the atomic numbers. He said that the properties of every element varies with atomic number, not with atomic mass. And the modern periodic table is in accordance with the modern periodic law. So here we can see the modern periodic table along with the law. This is the structure of modern periodic table. So what are the different trends or in the modern periodic table or anomalies of modern periodic table? So isotopes are placed at one place in the same groups. There is no element between hydrogen and helium, as atomic masses always comes in whole numbers, and atomic number is represented by Z. Atomic number is represented by capital Z, and it is equal to the number of protons in the nucleus of the atom. There are about 18 vertical columns known as groups and 7 horizontal rows known as periods. Elements having same number of valence electrons are placed in the same group. That means the element which have the same number of valence electrons, they are present in the same group, and as we go down in a group, number of cell increases. Elements having same number of occupied cells are placed in same periods, and each period has a new electronic shell getting filled. Number of elements placed in a particular period depends on the point how electrons are filled into various cells. To find out the number of electrons in a cell, do you remember 2n square formula? And already we have studied in class 9, 2n square formula. So to find out the number of electrons in a shell, 2n square formula can be used, where n is the shell number. So valence electrons also determines the number of bonds which is formed by an element. So there are modern periodic table. In modern periodic table, elements are arranged in increasing order of the atomic numbers in the form of table having 7 horizontal rows of elements called periods and 18 vertical rows of elements called periods. And groups, already we have discussed. And what are the properties of elements in periods and in groups? So what are the trends in modern periodic table? Valency and valence electrons. So on moving left to right in a period, so as we move from left to right in a period, valency increases and then it decreases. So valency, first of all, it will increase and then it will decrease. So I think all of you know what is valency. What is valency, children? Yes, number of valence electrons present in the outermost cell of an atom. Number of valence electrons present in the outermost shell of its atom. So on moving from left to right in a period, valency increases and then it decreases. But it remains same down in a group. As we move from left to right in a period, valence electron increases and remains same as we go down the group. As here we can see the example. Here we can see ki valency increases and after that valency remains the same down in a group. Next is valency we have seen. Atomic size. What is atomic size? Atomic size refers to the radius of the atom. Atomic size refers to the radius of an atom. It may be visualized as the distance between the center of the nucleus and the outermost shell. So atomic size or radius decreases from left to right along a period due to an increase in nuclear charge, which tends to pull the electrons closer to the nucleus. Here we can see the trends in atomic radii. So what is metallic properties? What is metallic properties or what are metallic characters? So metallic character means the tendency of an atom to lose electrons. So metallic character means the tendency of an atom to lose electrons. Metal occupy the left hand side of the periodic table. As the effective nuclear charge acting on the valence shell's electron increases across the period, the tendency to lose electrons, that is metallic character, will decrease. Down the group, the effective nuclear charge experienced by valence electrons is decreasing because the outermost electrons are further away from the nucleus. Therefore, these can be lost easily. Hence, metallic character increases down the group. So, what is non-metallic property? Electronegative nature. So, non-metals are electronegative as they tend to form bonds by gaining electrons. So, non-metal occupies the right side of the periodic table. So, non-metallic character increases across a period because due to increase in effective nuclear charge, that means tendency to gain electron increases. And non-metallic character, that is electronegativity, decreases down the group as the size of the atom increases, due to which the attraction of the nucleus for the incoming electron is less. So, these are the trends in modern periodic table.